Padmanabham, and today my topic is about SWOT analysis. So, what is SWOT? SWOT is a study undertaken by a company, a person, or an organization to identify the internal strengths and weaknesses and external opportunities or threats. S stands for strengths. So, strengths is it is a thing in which company does well. The value stands for weaknesses. Weaknesses is the things in which the company does not do well. O stands for opportunities. Opportunities are the conditions which favor the strengths of the company. T, threats are the conditions in which strengths are the things in which company is good at. W stands for weaknesses. Weaknesses are the things in which the company is not good at. O stands for opportunities. Opportunities are defined as the conditions which favor the strengths of the companies. T stands for threats. Threats are defined as the conditions in which the company does not favor the strengths, but it favors the components examining the internal strengths and weaknesses of SWOT are as follows. Production costs, marketing skills, financial resources, brand image of the company, technology and employee capabilities. Scanning helps identify the opportunities and threats. The environmental factors are as follows: political or legal factors, social factors, natural factors, demographic factors, which includes cultural factors as well. Demographic factors. Competitors. And technological factors. I took my analysis and I have taken a cosmetic brand called Elucidates. The strengths are excellent pricing strategy. It is very affordable. Good R&D. Strong distribution channels. Coming to the weaknesses, use of hard chemicals is a weakness for elating lipsticks, and the quantity and quality, the two cues. Customers claim that the quantity and the quality do not match with the product. Opportunities. These products can be used in beauty salons. It is a great opportunity for elating. The growing awareness about cosmetics in Indian women.
क्या कर रहे हो? अरे आवाज आ रही है.
Collaborate with multinational brands. Coming to the threats, it is said that reports say that there is a presence of lead in lipsticks of elating. Fake or counterfeit products are a very big competition to elating. There is a very good pricing strategy from different local brands as well as multinational players. So this is about the SWOT analysis of the company's macro environment. There are many forces, external forces, which affect the company's macro environment. Certain factors help in shaping of the strengths and opportunities of the company, whereas the other factors pose a threat and weakness to the company. Let us see. PEST is political, P is political, E is economical, S is social, and T is technological. All these factors, they affect the company either positively or negatively. They all are interrelated with each other. So as I told you before, PEST is the acronym for political, economical, social and technological factors. So PEST, it is also described as a strategy tool which is used for the measuring of the business growth or decline, the business potential and the business directions. This PEST analysis is often used with other analytical tools like Porter's five forces and SWOT analysis, which gives a very clear-cut definition about the situation, which are related with the internal and external factors as well. Coming to P, political factors. Political factors include the new government rules, government agencies, legal laws, and also the pressure groups which affect the marketing of the new businesses. Due to over-increasing globalization, new political laws and regulations, the companies, the importing companies and the exporting companies, the domestic and the foreign companies as well, are facing certain trade relations. They are having certain trade relations and they are either positive or negative. Both the marketers and the companies as well as the companies have to know about the new laws and regulations. These laws shouldn't affect the consumers and the competitors as well as the society. Now, these laws should be read at a very local level, national level and international level. Coming to economical factors. It includes the consumer buying behavior, the buying patterns, their spending patterns and the income what they get. Economical conditions affect not only the person, the consumer, but also the country. So it also tells about the interest rates, the business cycle the company follows, and also inflation. Now coming to social factors. Social factors tells about the consumer's behavior, his attitude, the demographical factors, his education, his level of understanding about the product. Because of social factors, it gave rise to many new marketing elements like corporate social responsibility, emphasis on ethics, and CSR, like corporate social responsibility. Technology. Technological factors, it tells about innovation and technology. How the technology is either positively or negatively impacting the consumer or the product or service in the marketplace. Now coming to the examples of PEST. Political. World Trade Organization has reduced the tariff and non-tariff barriers to encourage trade between the new countries. Economical. As we all know that India is a developing country. So many middle class people are there. So Tata Motors have identified the middle class segment of India, have introduced Tata Nano, a car which is affordable by most of the middle class people. So it comes under economical factor. Social. A company, a FMCG company called P&G has introduced a program called Siksha. It educates poor children in that. The best company in the world is Apple. It combines technology with innovation. So this is all about PEST analysis. Thank you.